Another cool feature about Galactic Attack is that frequently it gives you a chance to pick off some of the enemies when they're flying in below you before they come out and attack you. This game is a lot of fun for repeat gameplay as well. You can just play it over and over and over again, continuously find new ways to beat things and new tricks, which is really what any good shooter should do. And look at this, we have a flying wing with spaceship laser guns and missiles and stuff all over it. I've never seen anything like this in a game before. Yeah, well, Galactic Attack pretty much has all of these stereotypical spaceship shooter end bosses covered. There's not a lot in here that you haven't seen before. It's the gameplay that elevates Galactic Attack to the Sega Saturn must-own game status. Oh, flying wings. Will they ever learn? All those guns, they slow you down. If only you were a giant tunnel-crawling space spider with laser cannons, now then you'd have a fighting chance. Yep, backed into another parking meter. Great job! Well, if you want to find a good shooter for the Saturn that doesn't break the bank, Galactic Attack is the one to go for. Darius Gaiden is another one. That's a horizontal shooter, I've previously reviewed that. So watch my review of Layer Section. The game keeps going for a few more levels, you can continue several times. It's an awesome, highly underrated title these days, Galactic Attack. I almost forgot to mention you can also play a two-player co-op game on screen at the same time, which is a lot of fun. That's the end of this two-part review, and make sure you check out the Classic Game Room website for reviews of numerous other spaceship shooters. It's one of my favorite genres, so I play a lot of them.